You're going down, Benrus!
Oh, we have a couple of HJY listeners who are part of the HJY golf team. We've got Brian and Peter, and they got on the team, like all Rhode Islanders win things, they paid us money under the table. So thank you very much, guys. No, it was a legit radio contest. We had about 20 listeners qualify, and these two were picked out.
I knew a dirty joke punchline.
What's the punchline?
Punchline was your stance was a little too wide.
The joke is there is a woman on the golf course, and she gets stung by a bee. So she runs into the clubhouse, and the pro says, "What happened?" She goes, "I got stung between the first hole and the second hole." And the punchline is?
Sounds like your stance is too wide.
If there are any questions about my score, like some eraser marks, will there be a Wells report?
There could be a Wells report.
Okay, all right. I just want to get that.
It could be a Wells, and it could be 4 months in the making.
Okay. I want irrefutable evidence. I don't want just hearsay. Okay.
Inflated balls.
All right. Yeah.
Are they inflated
to
the proper
right.
PSI?
Yep, these are good. Yeah.
All right. Good.
Well, you had a hole in one?
I did. Unfortunately, I had it in my golf league at North Kingstown, which was like 40 drunks to begin with. Everybody witnessed it, and it set me back $260 at the bar. And my wife just didn't understand the rule of why the person with a hole-in-one has to pay for drinks. But it's a Scottish game, and I guess they're cheapskates, so hence the rule.
Yeah, after Paul told his story about how he had to pay $240 to pay for everybody's drink after a hole-in-one, I told my story how I didn't have to pay anyone because it was an open bar. When I got done, it was a bachelor party, so it didn't cost me anything.
Welcome to the jungle. We got fun.
What kind of shot was that?
It's called lucky. That's what qualifies as lucky. I almost hit your camera.
Thank God your aim's off. I stood behind the hole. I knew I was safe.
Is it that bad?
You'll see. You allergic to poison ivy?
Oh, a little bit. That's my ball. Oh, geez, this looks like the beginning of a horror movie. You know, I came out of there okay, except that I have three deer ticks sucking blood off my neck right now.
Welcome to the jungle.
You always have to ask a man before you straddle their line.
From Narragansett, Doug Palmieri. Ooh, that's going right at the pin. That might be worth $10,000. Uh-oh, a little strong off the green. He better stay out of the gym.
I like to watch Powell when he hits a golf ball. He's very strong through his lower body. Look at him, he's just sitting there showing us his butt.
I watch him do a lot of things. Shower, you know, get sweaty.
Boom!
But at least I finally did something right with a golf club, which is a rarity.
Once I get in the sand, all bets are off. I cannot get out of the sand.
Damn steroids kicked in at the wrong time, huh?
It ain't for the chippy birdie!
No, it's not going to do it.
Come on. Always my fault.
There you go.
No
nice.
Horseshoe. No lip.
No horseshoe.
No nothing. Dead center.
Center of the cup.
Center cut.
A little late.
Yes, birdie.
What about you, Brian? How many holes in one you hit?
Yet. Two times I've had a half a putt ahead away, but haven't cashed it in yet.
Now's the time?
Now's the time. This is worth 10 grand. I mean, I don't want to do it for free. I want to do it when I'm worth something. So this is it. It'll be 10 grand. I got two shots left at it.
Almost?
Ding, ding, that much.
He's agreed to share the $10,000 for the hole-in-one. He's been close several times today, and this one looks really good. Going right at the pin.
He's got a chance.
Get up. Oh, nice shot.
The hole-in-one is still $10,000.
Thanks a lot.
That was awesome.
Oh, guys, that's great.
Thanks, sir.
The choices, that was fun.
Yep.
Bank account is no fatter, unfortunately. But lost a few balls, so overall, fantastic day. Thanks to the Preserve for holding the Benrus Open. And then on to the finals, right?
Mm-hmm.
Good luck.